Okay, so we move to the last talk of this session, which is entitled Partial Collision Attack on the Round Reduced Compression Function of SCIME 256 by Hongbo Yu, Chiazhe Chen, and Xiaoyu Wang, and Hongbo Yu will give the talk.
Hello, everybody. This is the talk work with Chiazhe Chen and Xiaoyu Wang. My title is Partial Collision Attacks on the Round Reduced Compression Function of SCIME 255. This is the outline. We first give brief description of SCIME, then give previous results related to near collision or partial collision on SCIME. Finally, we give our text. SCIME is one of the SHA-3 final finalists. Even though the SHA-3 competition is over, the Kachak is the winner of SHA-3, but SCIME is still a strong SHA-3 candidate. SCIME is designed by Neil Ferguson, Stanford Lucas, Bruce Shannon, etc. SCIME uses a unique block iteration based on block cipher 3 fish. It supports the international state size 256, 512, and 1024. SCIME 512 is the primary proposal. It's also the SHA-3 version. The SCIME 256 is a low memory variant, also a tiny version of SCIME. In this paper, we give some near collision attack for SCIME 256. The compression function SCIME is designed in the MMO mode based on block cipher. It's designed HI equal to E or plus M, where E is the block cipher 3 fish and M is the plain text. The block size can be this this three kind of, the H is the key with the same size as M. T is the twig. The three fish block cipher consists of 62 rounds. Its current is the MIX functions. Three fish do not use S-box. The non-linearity mainly comes from the addition rotation by a constant and the XOR oppositions. The MIX function is opposite on 264 words to another to another 46 bit words. The key scheduler generates the sub key from the mask key and the trick values. The sub key consists of three contributions: the key, the twins, and the counters. Near collision and partial collision. From the handbook of applied cryptography, the near collision resistance is defined by it should be hard to find any two input M and M star with M not equal to M star, such that the HM and HM star differ in only a small number of bits. I think maybe the small number should be smaller than 1/3 of the full size, maybe. The general complexity of near collision is given in the first report of this morning. In this paper, we find a W bit near collision means a pair message M and M star. They collide n in W bits of the four sets, that is say HM R plus HM star, the Hamming weight is equal to N minus W. This is a general attempt. The lower bound of the time complexity is small than 2 to the W over 2, but the memory is more than 2 to the N minus 2. So if attacked, the complexity is larger than this lower lower bound, we use another notion to express it, the partial collision. A W-bit partial collision means a pair message M and M star collide in the fixed W bits. The general attack the complexity is 2 to W over 2. The first near collision attack is provided in HCrypt 2009. MC etc. or 30 round near collision with a practical complexity. In CANS 2002, Su etc. improved the near collision by stress the this differential path in the backward and forward. But the complexity is not practical, and the heavy weight in the near collision is very heavy. It's about a half of the n, a half of n. In FSE 2012, Lee etc. gave some free star collisions for skin 2. 112. This is for hash function version, and this is for complexity version. They converted the pre-attack on skin to the clear attack on skin, but the complexity is much lower than the exhaustive search. In this paper, we give several results on skin 256. Firstly, we give a practical attack for 24 round skin. The we give the active bits is only two active bits. Then give a 28 round practical near collisions, the active bits about 34, and another 28 round near collisions. Finally, we give a partial collision on 32 round. Why we call it a partial collision? Because the complexity is is bigger than the general, the lower bound of the general attack, so we call it a partial collision, not a near collision. The basic idea of attack, the previous work on related to the differential path, usually use the simple differential path, only zero different local 8 round local differential path is first is built. Usually zero path. Then stress the path in the backward and forward to get a path. In this model, we need we know the in the first pass in the top pass the difference in the near collision is very heavy, as the example in CANS 2010. It's about a part of bits is active. A natural idea is to how to connect the two simple paths into a one, a long one. In this way, if we can connect it, then we can get a long differential path with low Hamming weight in the first round and the last round. In order to connect our differential path, we firstly select the sub-key difference. We select a difference in the significant bits in K3 and 2-0. Then we can one can construct a 4-0 differential path in the middle for the first differential path and 4-0 path for the second path. This is our differential path. The first path consists of 20 rounds, and the second path consists of 12 rounds. We divided the path into three paths. The first path is a simple differential path. It only uses linear expression. And the second path is in the bottom. This part is also use a linear expression. In the round, in the middle, we use the 8 rounds differential characteristic to connect these two part simple paths. We first select the round 20 as the connection point because in this round the subkey is evolved. If we want to connect the two part, the only thing is intermodular differential in H20 is equal. If we select another round, not only the modular differential, but not modular difference, but also the XOR difference, both should be equal. So we select the round 2T as a connection point. Firstly, we connect N20 and C20. We by adjust the difference from H21 to H24. Then we connect B20 and D20 by just adjust the difference from H60 to H90. In our attempt, we use two kinds of difference mode, the SOR difference and the internal modular substitution difference. This is the process of our the connecting process of our attempt. Firstly, we connect A20. We select the top N20 as the target. In order to get the same difference in the bottom path, we give a bit carry by B20. The bit carry will cause the bit carry to A21 and D21. And D, if we select D21 to get the bit carry, then we have to continue to expand B22 and or C22. In this way, we can adjust the difference of A20 by adjust these words in the bottom, these words. In the same way, we can connect the C20 to match this C20 in the bottom. Once the A20 and the C20 is decided, we connect the B20 and the D20 by adjust these words on the bottom, these words. For example, the B20 can be obtained by D19 or A19, and the D19 can be obtained by B18 or C18. Once an assistant appears, we have to jump back the earlier step and make a different difference decision. The process of connecting is a hard work, but fortunately, Garrett Laurie also gave an automatic method to generate the differential path and recently got the similar results with our attempt. This is our differential path. From the differential path, we know even in the middle rounds of path, is the difference in our path is very sparse. We use the modular difference in these positions. That is to say, the position after the key is involved in A and C position, because in this position, they are not included in the XOR operator, only in the modular addition operator. This is the condition distributions. Once we get a differential path, we have to deduce a series of sufficient conditions. Then we divide the sufficient condition into three groups. So one group is mainly from the conditions in round 16 to 20, and the conditions in group two, the conditions is in round 20 to 22, and the C16, because C16 is determined by P5. And the group three, the conditions in group three include the other conditions in the other rounds. There are 216 conditions in group one, and 168 conditions in group two, 104 conditions in group three. From this table, we also know the first condition is only concerned with H20, and the conditions in group 2 is related to K5, and the other conditions related to K4, K4B, and K4D. So we can divide our attack into three paths. The first phase search 256 bit H20 to fulfill the conditions in rounds 16 to 20. We use the message modification technique. After the message modification, the time complexity is about 2 to 42. In the second phase, we search 256 bit K5 to fulfill rounds 20 and 24, and the conditions in C16. We also use the message modification and to cancel most of the conditions. The complexity in this path is only 2 to 18. The last phase is search 128-based K4B and K4D to fulfill other rounds. we use the message modification to fulfill the conditions in 12 to 60 round, and the other conditions can be searched. So based on our attack, we can complete the complexity of our attack. For the 32 round differential path, if we want to get a partial clearance with 15 bits difference of near clearance, we can the complexity is the addition of these three parts. It's dominated by the third phase the complexities. In the attack of 24 round, the complexity is 2 to 42. In this part, in fact, the phase 2 and the phase 3 are cooperated because in this part, we don't need the degree of freedom of from the twink. That is to say, the twink can be arbitrary. The 28 round near clearance, the complexity is dominant by the final pass. Now we give the analysis of degree of freedom. The total degree of freedom comes from the message, the mask key, and the chink. The altogether 640. The number of conditions in our differential path, in our 22 differential path, is 288. So it's enough to carry out our attack. Let me see the local degree of freedom. In the round 16 to 20, the freedom is 256, come from 820. The number of conditions in this pass is 216. The degree of freedom in round 20 to 24, number in this part, the number of conditions is 168, so it's enough to search a key. And in the third part, the degree come from come from chink, but the come from K4, K4B and K4D. The number of this part is 104, so it's sufficient. In order to verify our differential path, we give three examples. The first example is a near clearance with Hamming weight only 2 from round 4 to 28. In this example, the twink is fixed. In fact, it can be any arbitrary values except the difference in the most significant bits. This is a clear example from round 0 to 28, and the twink is a select twink. This is a clearance from rounds 4 to 32. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, so unfortunately we are quite late on the schedule, so I don't think we have so much time for questions. So let's thank this last speaker and all the speakers of this session again.